Hi, this is Pat Love with Pat's Two Cents. Reading Ezekiel chapter 18, verse 20, followed by Pat's Two Cents. The soul that sinneth, it shall die. The son shall not bear the iniquity of the father, neither shall the father bear the iniquity of the son. The righteousness of the righteous shall be upon him, and the wickedness of the wicked shall be upon him. Mm-hmm. Now, I'm going to read a little further. Verse 21. But if the wicked will turn from all his sins that he hath committed, and keep all my statutes, and do that which is lawful and right, he shall surely live. He shall not die. Now, I'm going to talk about a little something. One of the most frustrating things that happened to us is when, let me get this, give me a second. One of the most frustrating things, we're sitting in the car, we're sitting in the park, we're on our lunch break, at work, whatever. Wherever we are. And we press the button to turn on our cell phone. And we hold it, and it doesn't come on. Okay. And as we sit there and it doesn't come on, we are holding it, and then, okay, finally it's coming on. Takes a while to light up. And then all of a sudden, as we start to push some buttons, the thing dies out on us. Powering off. Well, how are we going to deal with something that's powering off when we need to use it? We need to use this phone. So we don't need this thing powering off on us. You know, so we're pushing buttons. We're like, come on, come on. And we try it again. And we try it again. And before we know it, shutting down. It's like, what? What the heck is going off? Well, that ain't gonna do me no good. How am I gonna make a phone call? I need to reach somebody, and I need to reach them now. Really? Well, how do you think God feels when he calls you to serve him? He has given you the power. He has anointed you. He has gifted you with giftings and callings. And now is your time to serve him. And you step up to that pulpit or to the choir or whatever you're doing in the church. And all of a sudden, no power. Well, here's the thing. If there's no power, you're useless. Can't do nothing with you. Now, you may run your mouth, but if there's no power, there's no anointing. If there's no anointing, there are no yokes being broken. Am I right? Because the Bible says it's the anointing, not the gift. It's the anointing that breaks the yoke. How are you going to have the anointing living in a bunch of sin? How can you be clean and filthy at the same time? How can you smell sweet and stink at the same time? Take a bath, baby, before you put that cologne on. Because it's going to foul it up. When you are living a life as a double agent in the kingdom of God, what you are doing is you are leaving proverbial droppings everywhere you go in the church. You step up to the pulpit, pile of poop there. You step down at the altar to pray for somebody, pile of poop there. You sit down in the pew, pile of poop there. You're not spreading the anointing. You're spreading your uncleanness because you are living in sin. You are committing adultery, fornication. You are living a life of hatred, meanness, abuse, wretched corruption. Got a nasty attitude. You're a liar. You're a conniver. You're a thief. You're screwing somebody else's wife or somebody else's husband. Or trying to. And you think God is blind? When you look around, you don't see God anywhere. You know how to preach. You know how to sing. Oh, you got the church rocking, baby. You don't need all the anointing. You got you, right? No. The people may be fools who have no idea what discerning of spirits really is about. You may have them fooled, but by God, you don't have him fooled. Not God. You do not have him fooled. And he is not a happy camper watching you spread your dung and your droppings all over his sanctuary, smearing it on his saints. So I ask you, when you go to church, when you step up in that pulpit to preach, when you step up there to sing, when you usher, those of you who are deacons, elders, whatever, what are you leaving behind you? The sweet anointing of the Holy Ghost that breaks yokes? Or the nasty dung marks and the droppings from your filthy lifestyle? Only you can answer that question. God already knows.